anyone explain what is an article?
This call is now being recorded.
Fatima, yes, you raised your hand.
Yes, we had an answer.
Everybody will not speak. Fatima will speak, okay? If you want to speak, you have to raise your hand. So let Fatima finish better. Yes, Fatima, tell me.
We had the noun.
We had the nouns? No. Rafiq Bodiwala has raised the hand. Yes, beta. Rafiq Bodiwala.
A and M. Me. A and N is a article. A, E, I, O, U are vowels.
Okay.
And rest if, of them is
consonants. Yes. Consonants. And when do we put a and an N? When do we use A and N? Okay, Fatima, the other one, Fatima Zahra or somebody who's raised the hand. Not Zahra, Fatima, other one, she's raised the hand. Please tell me. Fatima? Fatima, you just raised your hand. Not Zahra, other one. Yes, Fatima, you tell me. When do we use A and N? When do we use A and N? Okay, Fatima has raised the hand, but she's not speaking, beta. I'm asking you, Fatima.
Excuse me, ma'am. I know. Yes, there is other Fatima also.
She has raised the hand.
She's not saying anything.
Yes, Fatima Zahra. Yes, please tell me fast. When do we use A and N? Come on, tell me.
The word start with the vowel and A, E, I, O, U. The example for apple.
An apple.
So, an owl. Because there is A. A-E-I-O-U. Then an owl.
Let me explain. Because the word begins with the vowel, we have to use A-N. And if it is singular, tell me singular, plural hai. If it is apples, then we say an apple?
Yes.
We say an apple when we say apple? Plurals bolte hai, jaise ki apples. Then we use an?
No.
Only when there is one, singular. Then we use an apple. Okay? So just yes. Tell me fast, beta.
Only the apple is one, then only we use an. There are more, so we will not use an.
Fatima. Yes, tell me fast. You raised your hand, but you're not saying anything.
Yes, ma'am. What is your question?
My question is, can you tell me what is where do we use A and where do you use an?
Yes, then an apple, an aeroplane, that is.
Yes, better. Who said can I? Please explain.
I, Saima.
Yes, Sania, please.
When vowels are there, then we put an. And when consonants are there, then we put A.
But also remember that we put A or an only when it is singular. Remember, when it is plural, we don't use an. Okay? Remember.
If there is singular, then only we use A or an. If there is plural, then we do not use.
Okay. And then in certain cases, we use an even if there is no vowel because the first letter sounds like a vowel, we use an. Or sometimes we use a when even there is a vowel. For example, one-eyed man. O-N-E-1. Now the word begins with O. But we use a because one sounds like W-O-N or Y-O-N. Okay. So, because the sound doesn't sound properly. It doesn't sound like O. And it sounds like W-O. So, we use a, okay? We don't use an. Remember, suppose it's an R, you know, you're talking about H O U R R. H is silent and the sound is like R. So we use an R. In the same way, honest. Honest, we don't say honest. H is silent. The sound is like a O. So it sounds like honest. So because it sounds like honest, it sounds like O, we use and. Remember. So these things have to be remembered. Okay. Now, I also, and these, let me also tell you that these are also definite articles. Indefinite articles. Meaning they are not definite. Definite means when you're talking about something particularly, this particular thing or that particular thing. But indefinite is you're talking about anything. Like you're talking about apples means it can be any apple. I'm not talking about that particular apple. Okay. So when you're talking about something that is indefinite, we say it's an indefinite article. Okay. We're talking about an umbrella. It can be any umbrella. If you're talking about orange and any orange, we don't know which particular orange. But suppose I say that the Nagpur oranges are very tasty, very sweet. No, so here I'm talking about particular oranges. Which oranges? Nagpur oranges. The oranges that we get in Nagpur are very sweet. So I'm talking of those particular ones. That's why we use the. Do you all understand? Then I will proceed. Do you all understand?
Yes.
Okay,
ma'am.
Let me present the screen.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, better.
You did say that we are doing chapter number 5 articles, but chapter number 4 is left to be.
I know that, but I told you that chapter number 4 is all about nouns, okay? So, I want to do something that is to do with nouns, and there are 3 chapters of nouns in that, if you look at the book properly. So, the next session, I will take all the three lessons together so that it covers the whole of nouns. Understood? Because if I try to cover the 3 lessons just now, then it will take a lot of time and we have very less time. Okay? We have very less time. That's why I have picked up a short lesson that is articles. And I even want to try to do one more lesson if possible. But first, let me finish this. And if we have the time, we'll do the some other lesson also. Okay?
Yes.
So, see, in the grammar, nouns, there are 3 lessons in between. Okay? There is nouns, noun number, noun gender, and pronouns. So these are all interrelated, interconnected. So if I teach you, it's better I teach all the 3 together rather than taking, one by one and leaving the articles in the middle. So I want to complete articles first.
Yes.
Okay. So we have done, yesterday we did all this. Now, yes, fill in the blanks. I told you to do on your own. Okay. So anyway, one by one, I read about, come on, tell me the answers first and you can write it also. Okay. Nice. Yes, better.
Can I?
1 second, better. The girl is asking some question, better. Ask me fast.
Ma'am.
Tell me. Huh? Tell me fast.
In that F question.
Ma'am, can I
A or N?
Huh?
In F question.
F question.
Yes.
I'm talking about question number 1. I mean, fill in the blanks.
Yes, fill in the blanks. F.
Oh, F1. She has made that. I will come to that later. First, let me ask the girls. Okay, Keshmani Fatima, you read the and tell the answers one by one. Okay, I read about, come on, be fast. I read about dash. First one.
Yes.
Tell me first one. First one. Tell me fast.
I read dash one-legged monster? Answer is A.
Okay. Then continue. You have to complete the whole exercise.
Yes, number B. Mr. Churchill was an Englishman.
Very good.
Answer is N.
A-N-N.
Then number three. The poor hero in the story was an honest man.
Honest, it is honest. Okay, pronounced as honest, not honest. Okay, yes, next.
Answer the girl. Then number four, the girl screamed on seeing dash occupies.
Octopus. Octopus is a sea animal with eight arms. Okay. Next.
Yes. Then next, Sri Lanka is island in the Indian.
It's not
Ocean.
Island. It's not island. This is island.
Yes.
So Sri Lanka. So is what? Is a or an?
Yes, is a.
No, you tell me the correct answer. Sri Lanka is?
An island.
Okay.
Is wrong answer.
The answer is an island.
Yes.
Continue.
She has made dash exclusive list of fruits to be served at the pub. Answer is A.
No, this is wrong.
And
she has made an exclusive. Okay.
Okay. Then number G, the cow is a gentleman.
The cow is a gentle animal. You're written gentleman. Okay, next.
Then the soldier lost an arm.
The soldier lost an arm. Not shoulder, soldier.
Yes, soldier. Then number I. I returned home dash hour ago.
I returned home an hour ago. Okay, next.
I had a slice of pizza for lunch.
Okay, now this girl had a doubt. Number F. She made an exclusive list of fruits. So as she's saying it, she's correct because the sound is coming like X. X, okay. Now A, E, I, O, U. Okay, so this I will clarify to you tomorrow, okay? Because I myself have a doubt over here because I find that an exclusive list is also correct and a exclusive list is also correct. But I will clarify the doubt because her doubt is correct when she says exclusive, okay? Now yes. We read all this, we completed this. And I also told you to, tell me... See, first, the rules for using definite articles. Now, I think I've explained this before, but you have to remember the rules. Now, now even one more thing, the definite article is referred to someone or something already mentioned. I had already told you yesterday with example that when you met somebody day before and you meet your next again with your friend, and you say that I met her yesterday, okay? Okay, so you already said, I'm talking about the girl I met yesterday. So I'm talking about the friend I met yesterday. So because you know that particular person, you have already mentioned that. So we talk about them as the and definite person. You're talking about a definite person you know. Okay, if you just meet somebody on the way as some girl, and then next day again she comes to you, then you don't remember saying, oh, this is the girl I met, Again, you meet, then you say the. But if you meet the first time, you say, this is a girl, look at this girl. She's always following me. So look at her. No, she's a girl I don't know. But when you know somebody, then use the. Okay? So remember, the definite article refers to someone or something already mentioned. Now, I told you to learn the rules for the definite article. So, let me see. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 rules. 13 rules you have to remember. So the first is when you refer to something which has already been mentioned. Suppose you have read a book. You say, I want the book I gave you. Or you tell the librarian, I want the book I was reading yesterday. So we are talking about that particular book. So that is one rule which is already mentioned. Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So okay, you understood. Now, we used to refer to people or objects that are unique. For example, the sun. So as I told you also yesterday, that I told you the sun is unique, the stars are unique, Taj Mahal is unique, the Statue of Unity is unique, the Statue of Liberty is unique. This is just one in a world or very rare, you know. So that when it is unique, we use the. Okay, the sun rises in the east, the stars shine in the sky. Yes, better.
Which page number is this?
What, better?
In which page number is this?
Page number 22.
Okay,
so these are the rules for the definite articles. When will you put the? So there are 13 points to remember where you can use the. So first point is when you have already seen or met somebody or you mentioned somebody. The second is when you're talking about something unique. We are talking about the star, the moon, okay. Then we use when things are uncountable. You can't count milk, you can't count juice, you can't count water. So you say, I spilled the milk or I drank the milk that mummy had left for me. So we talk about the, we use the when we are talking about uncountable things. If you can count, then you cannot use the, okay. But when you use uncountable, so the three things till now, one is when you mention somebody or you know someone in particular. Second is when it is something unique. The third is you use the when it is uncountable. Okay, so you know that sugar, all liquids, you know, like milk, juice, then water, then what is uncountable? You can say sugar, salt, all this is uncountable. Okay, better. It's okay enough. You can find out later. So you use when it is uncountable. Now, the fourth point is we use when it is superlative. Now when we're talking about she's the best girl, when we use superlative, you know what is superlative? Comparison, no? Good, better, best, or fast, faster, fastest. So fast, faster, fastest. Fast, faster is comparison, but fastest is superlative. Fastest is superlative. So when any superlative word comes, you use the before that. Okay, she's the fastest athlete in the school. She's the best girl in the school. Or she's the naughtiest girl in the class. Or she's the happiest person on this earth. So, you know, this is the tallest building. Okay, he's the shortest boy. So when you're talking about a word which is superlative, which has EST, remember, you use the. Okay, when you use comparative is smarter, better, okay, taller. These are comparatives. But superlative are when you're using tallest, best, then fastest, slowest, shortest, tallest. All these are superlatives. So remember, you have to use the before superlatives. Okay, now the fourth International Handicraft Fair will be held in September. Okay, now even we use for ordinal numbers. Look over here. We use for superlatives and we use for ordinal numbers. For example, first, okay, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. So we use the fourth International Handicraft Fair. So remember, till now, what are the points? Again, let me recap. First is when you already know somebody, mention somebody in particular. Second is you use the. Second is when you use when you're talking about something unique. The third is you use when you're using superlative and ordinal. Sorry. Third is when you're using uncountable things. Fourth is you use when you use superlatives or you use ordinal numbers. Ordinals are first, second. So the when I'm talking, she stood the first in class. Okay, she's the first girl to reach the ground. So when you're talking about the first, or she's the second girl to win the trophy. So, or he's the third boy who came racing, first in racing. So when we're talking about the ordinal numbers, remember, superlative and ordinal numbers, you use the. The fifth one is we use with adjectives. Adjectives are when you're talking about describing some noun, the rich, the poor, okay, the French, the Indians, the foreigners. So when you're talking about describing an adjective, when you're using adjectives, you use the. Okay, okay. We say she like the beautiful girl. Girl is a noun, and when you describe her, beautiful is an adjective. So we say the beautiful girl. Girls, you're understanding or not? Because I'm just going on explaining, and you should tell me whether you understood or not.
We understood, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. Then when we use a singular noun represent a whole class. For example, the spider has 8 legs. So when you're talking about a spider, spider is one. But we are talking about one particular, the particular species of spiders which have 8 legs. Okay. So when we're talking about a particular, a singular noun, but which stands for a whole class. Okay. So here, you say the pack of wolves. When you talk about wolves, you know, we say the pack of wolves. We don't say a pack of wolves. We say the pack of wolves. Okay. Then in the same way, there are so many others, like, you know, nouns which represent a whole. Okay. She went to the class. We say class because class stands for a room where all the students are there. Okay, so we can't use it as singular, but it's a singular noun, class, but it stands for a whole group. So she went to the class with her friend. Do you understand? I'm giving you a simple example, the class. Okay. Okay, we use when a singular noun represents a whole class. See, we don't use the when it is singular, but when a noun represents a whole class. For example, the whole class, the team, okay? The group, the mob, the audience. No, they are a whole group. Do you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Uh-huh. So when we're talking about the class, I'm saying girls go to the class. No, I cannot say go to a class because I'm talking about any class. But if I say go to the class, then you know that you have to go to your class only. So the class. Now class is singular, but which is made up of what? All the students in the class, isn't it? So when it is one singular word, singular noun, but standing for a whole group of people. Understood? Samajh mein aaya nahi hai? Okay. Okay. Now we also use the, when, that I said finished. Now we use the with the names of geographical rivers, mountain ranges, group of islands, canals and oceans. For example, the Himalayas are the tallest mountains in the world. The Nile is the longest river. The Amazon is the widest river. So when you're talking about everything geographical, okay, when you talk about geographical features, then we use the, okay? So remember, we till now again I repeat, what have we learned? We use the when we know somebody, we mention somebody or we know somebody in particular. Then we use the when we are talking about unique things. Then we use the when we are using uncountable things, okay? Then we use the when we are talking about superlative or ordinal numbers. Okay? Then we use the when we use a noun as a whole group. The class, the mob, the audience. Then we use the noun, the when we use geographical terms like the rivers, the mountains, the seas, the oceans. Okay. Now here we use the with the countries that include the word republic, kingdom or states. Okay, so we don't use the India, but we use the when we are saying the name of a country which has republic in that, kingdom in that or states in that. For example, the United States of America. We don't say USA or USA. We say the United States of America because states come in that, okay? Then we say the United Kingdom. UK. So United Kingdom, the kingdom comes there. So again, we use the. Okay. then the Republic of South America or Republic of Arabia, whatever. So when these three words come, we use the in a country, not for all the countries, remember. Do you all understand this or not? This is also important.
Understood. Yes.
Okay. So London is the capital of the United Kingdom. Chang's belong to the People's Republic of China. So when you're talking about a country which has republic, kingdom, or states in that, we use the. Okay. Now we use the with the countries that are plural names. For example, have you been to the Philippines? Okay, now Philippines is a name of a country, okay? But then you use S over there, say Philippines, okay? Then we use have you been to the Philippines, okay? Then in certain countries which has like that, you have to add the, okay? Now we use the, with the names of newspapers, for example, the Times of India, then the Gujarat Samachar, the Hindu, so all these are the Telegraph, all these are names of newspapers. So with names of newspapers, you use the. Okay. Then we use the with the names of the famous buildings, works of art, museum, or monuments. When you're talking about Taj Mahal or the Char Minar or the Red Fort, all these, you know, famous buildings, then we use the. When we use with organization, for example, the headquarters of United Nations is in New York. So when you're talking about an organization, okay, now we use the name with the hotels and restaurants. For example, the Ritz is located in Paris. Okay, now you're in, I don't know, but if you're talking about the Saffron restaurant, so we said the Saffron is on Vagavari Road. Okay, so or it's in Bhavnagar. So where you have to use the. So there are so many rules you have to remember for using the. All of you have understood now. First tell me.
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody has understood. So there are 13 rules, certain rules you have to follow when using the. So I want anybody, I don't want Muskan because she's already dead. What's her name? I want somebody else who has not spoken till now to tell me all the rules. Can anyone tell me? You can look at the book and tell me. Anyone can tell me better?
Can I see?
Yes, your name. Your name better?
Fatima Bahajat.
Fatima. Better be fast because you have to do the exercise also.
Yes.
Come on, be fast. When do we use the?
If you meet anyone and then again, so we will use the. And before superlatives,
Better be a bit loud.
We can use the before. We can use the before we mention some person.
Yes. Okay. Okay. You know, just make it short and fast. Okay.
Okay.
Then we use
then
the
when. We feel some unique things, then we use the.
Okay.
Singular noun represents.
That represents the whole class. Yes.
Then geographical areas.
Yes.
Then
superlatives and ordinals, don't forget. Huh?
Then before ES.
Huh?
Then before.
Better tell me.
Small S, smallest, longest, or shortest.
That is superlative or ordinal. Superlative and ordinals. Ordinals are what are numbers? What are the numbers of ordinals?
First, second.
Third. What are the ordinal numbers? First, second, third. Okay. Then we use the with countries.
United Kingdom and China.
No, not only two. Whichever country has the word republic, the kingdom, or the states in that, you will read with the. Okay. The United Kingdoms, the Republic of China, the United States of India. Okay, so of America, sorry. Okay. Then what will we use the for? complete with the first.
In the film.
When it is a plural, country's name is in plural, okay?
Then if we are talking about some newspapers.
Yes, you use the. And then?
If we are talking about famous building.
Yes.
Museums and mountains like that.
Very good.
Then
and then?
Use the United Nations.
Yes.
And
okay. And even for hotels, okay?
Hotel and restaurants.
Okay. Thank you, beta. Very good. So I hope all of you have understood. Now we will do this. Write the errors in the sentence. Beta Keshwani Fatima, your turn will come next. First is Baloch. Now who is here? You have to correct the sentence. Okay, correct the errors of articles used in the sentence. Now who is most famous athlete in the world? First one, Baloch.
Who is the most famous athlete in the world?
The world. Very good. So you have to write the whole sentence over here. Who is the most famous athlete in the world? Second one, Mount Everest is in Himalaya.
Mount Everest is in the Himalayas.
In the Himalayas. Very good. Next one.
I want to sit on beach and watch sun go down. I want to sit on a beach
on
a and beach. Watch
on very good.
Beach and,
okay.
And watch the sun go down.
Now listen, in this one, C one, I want to sit on a beach and watch the sun. Okay, remember, two are coming over there. I want to sit on a beach and watch the sun go down. Okay, so remember, all of you all, C, a beach and the sun. Next one, come on fast, beta.
Okay. Could you take garbage out, please? Could you take the garbage out, please?
Very good. The garbage out. Next is?
Andaman and Nicobar Islands are in Bay of Bengal. Andaman and Nicobar Islands are in the Bay of Bengal.
Very good. Next one?
She was born in the France. She was born in the France.
She was born in? No, France. The France is be there. Is it in plural? No, it is not in plural, no? She was born in France. The is cancelled over here. The is cancelled over here. Remember all of your girls? Number F, she was born in France. No the, okay? Now, computer, continue.
Computer is an useful machine. The computer is an useful machine.
No, better. Useful. Now, what is the sound of the useful? U. Does it sound like Y-O-U?
No, ma'am.
No? Computer is a useful. Computer is an useful. I feel computer is a useful machine. Because for me, U means Y-O-U. That Y, you know, sound is there. Useful. So you please put it, computer is a useful machine. Okay? Next one is the president. Come on, the president of the United States.
The president of United States is given a speech tonight. The president of United States is given speech tonight.
No, so what will be the answer? The president of the United States. When do you use the? When states or kingdom or republic come, okay? So the president of the United States, okay? Next one.
Education is one of most important things in life. Education is the one of most important things in life.
Education is one of the most. Education is one of the most, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Education
elephant
is
an intelligent animal.
Elephant is?
Okay.
Elephant is
a intelligent animal.
An intelligent
elephant animal. Is an intelligent animal.
Next.
Last year we visited Tower of London.
Very good.
Tanya received a letter yesterday. Letter was from her grandmother. Tanya received a letter yesterday. The letter was from her grandmother.
Very good. Tanya received a letter yesterday and the letter was from her grandmother. Okay. Now, will you fill in the blanks? I want somebody else now. First. Yes, Fatima. Better
please.
Everybody mute your mics except Fatima. Fatima, read. Come on, tell me the answers fast. We have to finish this.
Yes, ma'am. Sonali's father runs a shop in his locally. There are many ready-made.
One second. In your book, it is Sonali. In my book, it is Kokilas. So don't get confused. No? The Sonali.
Yes, ma'am. It is Kokilas.
Okay, but in one book which I read before, it was Sonali. So don't get confused if some other name is there. Okay. So Kokila's father runs.
Father runs a shop in his locality. There are many ready-made clothes in the shop.
Correct.
Sonali has never been allowed to touch the clothes.
One day
her father could not go to the shop because of an unexpected function. Sonali requests her mother to give the permission to go to the shop and handle the business there. A little boy entered the shop with an ice cream. Yes, ma'am. With an ice cream. Kokila was tempted on seeing the ice cream.
Yes.
She said, dear friend, give me the ice cream. The boy said, sure, I will share it with you.
Okay. So if you see in this paragraph, see a little boy. So first, when we see the boy, because we don't know him, we use a. Okay. A little boy entered the shop with an ice cream. So Kokila was tempted on seeing the ice cream. Yeah, it is not an. Okay. It is the ice cream because she knows he's holding the ice cream in his hand, that particular ice cream. So the ice cream. She said, dear friend, give me the ice cream. The boy said, now see, in the beginning it was a boy because she didn't know. But once he entered with the ice cream, she knew which boy she's talking about. So she says, the boy said, sure, I will share it with you. So all of y'all, I want to know, have you understood this thoroughly? Everybody, if there's any doubt, please ask me now.
No, ma'am, okay. I don't have any doubt.
So everybody must complete all the exercises, okay? I want you to complete exercise. First, we did one, then correct number two, then number three, I want that fill in the blanks. All should be completed today for your homework. Did you all understand better?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Excuse me, ma'am.
One girl.